Hi, I'm Justin from Sophos Support. Today, I'll show you how to manually install Sophos Endpoint. You may wish to manually download and run the installer if you have a small number of devices to deploy to, or if you need to test the product before deploying to the rest of your environment. I'll show you the steps to install on both Windows and Mac, so use the chapters to navigate to the relevant section. I'll start with Windows devices. To perform a manual installation, in Sophos Central, navigate to My Products. Then select Endpoint for a manual endpoint installation, or Server for a manual server installation. Click on Installers. If you do not wish to install device encryption, select Choose Components and deselect Device Encryption. This will only be visible if you're downloading the installer for Endpoint and are licensed to use device encryption. Click Download Installer once you've finished configuring the installer. Once the download completes, navigate to your Downloads folder and run the installer. Proceed through the installation window and prerequisite checks and begin the installation. The installation can take about 10 minutes to complete. Once finished, you'll see a completion message on the installation window. You can now perform tests on your device, such as launching commonly accessed internal applications. This ensures there are no conflicts before scripting out a deployment to the rest of your environment. To manually install on a Mac device, in Sophos Central, navigate to My Products, Endpoint, then click Installers. If you do not wish to install certain components, like Device Encryption or ZTNA, select Choose Components and deselect the components. The Device Encryption component is only visible to you if you're downloading the installer for Endpoint and are licensed to use it. Once you're done configuring, click Download Installer. Once the download completes, move the installer zip file to a location that isn't in user's Documents, Desktop, or Downloads folder. We recommend using the user's Home folder. You can use the shortcut Command-Shift-H to navigate there. Extract the zip file and confirm that the Apple Quarantine flag is set correctly by opening Terminal and running the following command. In some cases, downloaded files can have a com.apple.quarantine extended attribute, which prevents the execution of the file. To find more information about the quarantine flag, check out the KBA linked in the video description. If the command does not return com.apple.quarantine, proceed to the next step. However, if the command does return this, you'll need to run this command. Now, run the installer. The installation can take about 10 minutes to complete. You need to grant Sophos Endpoint security permissions to run on your Macs. You may need to do this more than once, as Apple frequently updates its security requirements. For more information, please check the documentation in the video description. As the installation progresses, you will be prompted to give permissions for Sophos Network Extension and Sophos ScanD. Click Open System Settings in the pop-up window. Click Allow and enter your Mac credentials to proceed. Click Allow again when prompted. Click Details and toggle on Sophos Network Extension and Sophos ScanD. Once done, close Privacy and Security and continue with the installation. Once the installation has finished, you will need to grant full disk access. To do this, click the Sophos icon on your menu bar and then click Open Endpoint Self-Help. Go to Services, and you will notice that Sophos Scan is not running. To fix this, click Prerequisites, and then click Allow Full Disk Access. Click the first step to open Privacy and Security Preferences. Drag the Sophos icon from Sophos Endpoint Self-Help to the applications list in Full Disk Access. You will be prompted to grant Full Disk Access to Sophos User Agent. You may choose to quit and reopen to give Full Disk Access, or you can click later to quit another time. You'll need to restart your Mac to give full disk access, but you will still be protected. In this case, I'll click Quit and Reopen, and then close the Privacy and Security window. Back in Sophos Endpoint Self-Help, click Services. You will notice that Sophos Scan is now running. When performing a remote deployment, these security permissions are granted during the deployment setup. That completes the installation, and you can now perform tests on your device. I hope you found this useful. Check out the documentation for this TechVid in the description. For further assistance, view and post questions on community.sophos.com and go to techvids.sophos.com for more great videos like this one.